Welcome to our MAXQDA video tutorial about data coding. Coding in MAXQDA means to assign segments of data, for instance a piece of text or part of a picture, to a category which is called a code in MAXQDA. As you might have learned in the Getting Started video tutorial, you can create new codes in the code system. To code a specific data segment with such a code, you drag and drop it onto the code. Afterwards, a coding strip with the code name appears next to the coded segment, the so-called coding. If you're coding pictures, as I do right now, the coded segment is also highlighted in the picture. When coding audio or video data, like in this example, the coding strip can be found in the area below the timeline. This basic procedure can now be modified with several functions, which I will show you next. If you, for instance, have just used a certain code and want to use it again for the next text segment, you can simply click on the code in the quick list of the code toolbar. If you follow the grounded theory approach and create a lot of new codes in the face of free coding, you might find the following shortcut helpful. Mark the text segment, right-click on it, and then choose Code with a new code from the context menu. The window for creating a new code will automatically appear and the code will be added to the code system. With this shortcut, you can skip a few steps of the standard procedure and thus free code much faster. If you want to assign several codes to a particular text segment at once, you can do that too. First, you activate the codes in the code system. Then, you mark the text segment, right-click on it, and choose Code with activated codes from the context menu. All activated codes will be assigned to the segment immediately. You can also choose to code in Vivo with MAXQDA. This means that you can use the text of the coded segment itself as the name of the code. Then you don't have to type in the name for each new code by yourself. To code in Vivo, you mark the segment in the text, right-click on it, and choose Code in Vivo from the context menu. MAXQDA automatically creates a code with the same name as the text of the segment and adds it to the code system. If the marked segment is very long, MAXQDA uses only the beginning of the text as the name for the code. And that brings us right to our next tip. If you have a lot of terms of the same kind and want to code them with the same code, you can use the autocode function of MAXQDA. You first click on Analysis in the menu and then Lexical Search. You use a search string to have MAXQDA find all the occurrences of this string in all your data. These results get listed in a separate window. You can then code these items with either a new or an already existing code. Right now I decide for the latter. Furthermore, you can choose to code not only the search string itself, but also the whole sentence or even the whole paragraph in which the string occurs. I decide now to code the whole sentence for the time being. As usually, one can then activate this new code as well as the desired document to list all the results or the sentences or paragraphs in which they occur in the retrieved segments window. Especially in the beginning of a new research project, you might first only want to mark important sections of the text with different colors, without assigning actual codes to them, as if you're working with a text marker. To do so, MAXQDA offers the highlighting code function. If the corresponding toolbar is not visible on your screen, you can open it by choosing the menu View and then Code. Once you have marked a segment of your data, you can choose among 5 different colors to code the segment with. In contrast to other codings, the highlight codings are actually highlighted in the text too, just as they would if you had marked the text with a highlighter. MAXQDA creates a new code with the name of the color in the code system, which you can afterwards use like any other code in MAXQDA. If you are interested in coding without words, you might find another function quite helpful, the Emoji Code tool. To start it, just click on the smiley icon in the upper code toolbar. This will open a window with different emoticons and icons that you can use to code your data. To code a segment with one of these icons, just mark the segment in the document browser and click on the chosen icon in the emoticode window. The coding strip next to the text as well as the code system will now show the icon instead of the name of the code. By using emoticodes, you can analyze your data without using words. Other than that, you can use them just like any other codes in MAXQDA. The next set of functions is designed to speed up your coding process. Let's say you use a set of certain codes very often. Instead of drag and dropping every code, you can assign keyboard shortcuts to these codes. Up to 9 of such key combinations are available. To assign a shortcut to a code, right-click on the code in the code system and choose Properties from the context menu. The drop-down menu Shortcut offers you a list of key combinations to choose from. Afterwards, you can assign this code to a highlighted text segment simply by pressing this key combination. For an overview of all key shortcuts that you have already assigned, you can open the list Keyboard Shortcuts for Codes via the menu Codes. It is also possible to assign or to change the codes for a specific key combination by dragging and dropping the new code to the respective shortcut in the list. A similar function is offered by the so-called code favorites, which can be especially helpful if you're working with a highly complex code system. You can access the code favorites window via the menu Code. In this window, new codes can be added via drag and drop from the code system and arranged as you like. To code a segment with a code favorite, simply mark the segment in a document browser and click on the code name in the code favorite window. Regardless of the kind of codes you use, you might want to adjust your codings every once in a while. To do so, you mark the corrected text segment, for instance, make it larger, like in this example, and then either drag the highlighted segment onto the code again, or right-click on the coding strip and choose Recode with Highlighted Segment from the context menu. If you want to recode pictures, you proceed in a similar way. Just mark the new area in the picture and recode either with drag and drop or with the context menu. Of course, it is also possible to simply delete a coding. To do so, you right-click on the coding strip and choose Delete from the context menu. As an alternative, you can undo the last 10 codings. Just click on the icon Undo Code in the code toolbar and choose the coding you want to undo. Another useful set of functions is a special context menu that helps you visualize your codings. You can open it by right-clicking on the gray area in the document browser, in which the coding strips are shown. In this menu, you can choose which codings are actually displayed in the document browser. For example, you can decide to show only the codings of activated codes or codings of a specific user. You can also choose to show only codes with special colors. In the bottom of the menu, there are several options on how the codings are displayed in the document browser. One of these options makes MAXQDA highlight the coded segments with the corresponding color of the codes. If you are coding pictures, you might also find it very useful to display or hide the coded segments in images. This way, the picture is not covered with the frames of the segment boundaries. Now, you do not only know the basic coding procedure in MAXQDA, but have the expertise to apply complex codings to your data. Of course, it would be possible to discuss the described functions in even greater detail. If you would like to catch up on all the coding functions and options in MAXQDA, you can consult the user manual, which can be downloaded from the MAXQDA website, or via clicking on Help and MAXQDA Reference Manual in MAXQDA itself.